Oops, I forgot to put the mic on. I was saying that we're cutting some strips for the intake manifold, and I want to see if one will make it here on this side. And it will not. So we might as well stop right where we're at. What I plan on doing is cutting little notches or little strips, little short pieces of strip, and put it in there and drill the holes. It should work out all right. All right, let's put these in upside down now. And then blow some chips out of there. That ought to do it. Just like that. Boy, I didn't leave too much extra on the edges. If I get the holes in the right spots. They should work. Now I'm going to take and go over the bandsaw again, and I'm going to cut these into strips, and we'll come back to the mill and we'll set up on the mill and set a stop, and then load them this way, and then clean up the edges. All right. So I will be back because I had to get done on the saw. Okay, we're going to put a stop in there to hold the parts off the edge here. There we go. And that should hold the part like that. And we'll take a scraper and put it on this side. Okay. That should do it. So we want 218 off of that back edge, and we'll go 230. 2 inches, 230 thou off that back edge. So we'll crank over here. Get the edge finder out. We're just still laying out from the other day. All right. So over here. We'll come over and pick up the edge of this edge finder, or the stop, I mean. Right there. Okay, so that's 100 over, and we're supposed to be 62 thou over. 62, that's 40. We'll leave it right there. And now we'll come back and we'll touch the back edge. I'm gonna zero my X. Move it over, come down. This, and we'll crank it in till it touches. Right there. That's 100. And now we want to go another 130. Right there. One zero it. Go back to zero on my X. Right there. That should be it. Okay. We're set for the first hole. Now, we could stack them up in there, since they're all cut the same width. Put a piece of cardboard in, or paper in the front. That'll hold them all in place. Or we can just do one at a time. And slide the parallel out. Put the big drill chuck in. And we are ready for the first small hole. Okay, now we're going to crank over 650. big drill. $325. We're gonna crank her back to, or not $325, to it. This is $325. That'll be right directly in the center of the two holes that we just put in. There we go. There's one right there. Take and file the burrs off. This file is getting dull. Let's see if I can get a different one here. This one is dull. Let's take the handle off. Usually you just give it a tap and it comes right off. All right, I'll go over here to the bench. Wow. That ain't one of those crank-on ones, is it? Yes, I think it is. I'll just lay this down. Yeah, see, it puts threads on the shank. Try this one. There we go. We'll have to do the same thing for our fixture. Only it's a different size small hole for the 256 threads. And let's get one of those out over here and put it up to it and make sure. Make sure that it looks right. It looks right to me. So, we need to drill all of these the same way. And I'll just slide the parallel back. Put another one in there. File the burrs off first. And it's going to take a while to get all these done. So I will end up doing them off screen. I'll do one more here. That's the big hole. $650. Alright, got another one done. Take the file and knock the burrs off the back. Come on. I see a little burr on there and it doesn't want to come off. This file is sharp now. I can feel it cutting when it's when I push forward on it. Take a burr quick. That puts a little radius on the leading on the edges that you hit with a burr quick. There we go. Two done. I got a long ways to go, and I'm not sure how many I need. So anyway, I'm going to do them off screen, off camera, and I'll be back when I get them done.